This is Mission Control Houston. This is a live view in the International Space Station Flight Control Room located at the Johnson Space Center in Houston, Texas. This is a view from the back of the room where 20 different flight controllers are at their console positions monitoring the vehicle systems and supporting the onboard crew, the Expedition 28 crew on board, now in the early part of their crew afternoon. Leading the flight control team today is Flight Director Jerry Jason, who is shown here in the center of your view. To his right in the red is veteran astronaut Shannon Lucid. She is representing the crew office at the Capcom console and serving as the voice of the flight control team as needed as they're working through their activities. The crew woke up at 1 a.m. Central Time, which is the standard wake-up time for the orbiting crew. They had their routine morning inspection of the vehicle and breakfast in their daily planning conference. Then they also had a routine flight director conference, which is a weekly activity, a chance to tag up with the supporting flight directors. The crew members also had hearing assessments this morning. Those were conducted by NASA astronaut Mike Fossum and JAXA astronaut Satoshi Furukawa. They also conducted an oxygen repressurization from the docked Progress vehicle. And Satoshi Furukawa has been continuing work with one of the Lego brick payloads on board the International Space Station. That payload is a series of toy Lego kits that are assembled on orbit and used to demonstrate scientific concepts. Some of these models include satellites, a space shuttle orbiter, and a scale model of the International Space Station. That video always available at the NASA and Lego websites. This is a view from the orbiting complex, now traveling at an altitude of 213 nautical miles, which is the equivalent of 243 statute miles above the Earth. At this time, the crew members are scheduled to be working on a variety of activities. NASA astronaut Mike Fossum is working on the Space Linear Acceleration Mass Measurement Device. That is a piece of hardware on board that helps the researchers follow Newton's second law of motion by having two springs generate a known force against a crew member mounted on an extension arm, that resulting acceleration being used to calculate the subject's mass. The objective of today's procedure was to instruct the crew on how to perform body mass measurements using the slammed hardware. The crew member will set up the software to perform body mass measurements and then conduct the mass measurements. Meanwhile, their Russian counterparts are working on maintenance and testing of the docking systems on the Poisk module in preparation for next week's undocking of the Soyuz TMA-21 spacecraft, that to begin the trip home for NASA astronaut Ron Garin, Andrei Borisenko, and Alexander Sumikhatayev. They worked on connecting the docking compartment, Kurs antenna feeder to the service module. They also performed physical exercise and Russian experiment work. JAXA astronaut Satoshi Furukawa has been working in the Japanese segment, specifically working on some payload computer configurations associated with the multi-purpose small payload rack. He's also been working on ARED, or the Advanced Resistive Exercise Device, maintenance. And NASA astronaut Ron Garin is working on some hardware configurations associated with the Glacier 2, which is one of the freezers on board the space station. Their end of day will include private medical conferences for Mike Fossum, and the team will end their day with a daily planning conference at about 1:50 p.m. Central Time, followed by off-duty time. They're scheduled for crew sleep at 4:30 p.m. Central Time.